I grew up in Monticello, Georgia, which is a small town about 90 miles south of Atlanta. My paternal grandmother was the daughter of John S. Williams. He died long before I was born. But I heard from my uncles, from my father, from people who knew him, that he was a wonderful man. He was well respected in the community.
In 1921, almost 18 years after the peonage trials, federal investigators visited the Williams farm to follow up on reports that he was holding peons.
There's a group of black men out in the field. The men are obviously terrified, unwilling to say almost anything. They're emaciated. They clearly have been terribly abused. John Williams suddenly appears.
He pleads that he didn't know this was against the law, that he'll do better. His intentions were good, very apologetic to these federal officials. And they leave. And he doesn't know what they're going to do. He knows they found evidence that he was holding these people in slavery. He talks to his foreman, Clyde Manning, and says, as the court transcript said, we've got to do away with these boys.
The family story was that he had worked prisoners on his farm, that they were hardened criminals and they had been put in the penitentiary for a long time. And one night, a lot of the prisoners tried to escape. And he, along with other farmers who were working these men, tracked them down and, in the process of recapturing them, killed some of them. Then, sometime later, the story came to light for me. It was, of course, totally different from the story that I had heard.
Williams and Manning, the black foreman, systematically hunted and murdered 11 black workers. Some were bludgeoned. Others were weighted down with chains and forced into a nearby river. Another was made to dig his own grave.
They did it in the most horrific ways that you can imagine, that I really can't talk about. So emotional. I think about not just the fact that these men were murdered, but the cruelty with which it was carried out. And that's what's hardest for me to imagine and hardest to accept.
And it came to light only because a little boy was fishing down by the creek where they'd thrown some of the bodies, and one of the bodies came up.
In the spring of 1921, Williams and Manning each faced an all-white jury in a Georgia state court. Both were found guilty and given life sentences. Within a decade, both had died in prison. Williams was the first Southern white man since 1877 to be indicted for the first-degree murder of an African-American. It would not happen again until 1966. The following year,